she awake yet?
Lil, of course not.
Should I wake her?
Oh, let her sleep. It's her birthday.
No, I'm gonna be the first to wish her a happy one.
Oh, you.
I'm gonna wake her.
John.
Happy birthday, Lil!
Oh, it's my birthday!
You're 13 today! Come on, you!
Where's my birthday breakfast?
Royal Highness Princess Lillian wishes to be served her birthday breakfast!
The Royal Highness will have to wait.
But it's my birthday!
It's her birthday! She sounds hungry!
I told you not to wake her yet, John.
Did you hear that? You're gonna have to go back to bed! Wake! Poor princess!
Well, enough nonsense. John, we need more firewood.
I'm sorry, did you hear something?
Oh, please.
Please what?
Enough silliness.
I don't know who's talking to me.
Please. Sir John, could you get some firewood?
With pleasure.
Oh, there you are, my darling.
What kind of tea is it? I'll not drink it if it's bitter.
It's perfectly good tea, Lil. Now drink. It's good for you.
It's bitter.
No, it's not. Stop this silliness. Drink the tea. It's good tea.
But Mama, it's my birthday.
Oh, very well. Give it here. Oof.
Can I go to Grandmother's after breakfast?
Well, I was thinking we would have our own celebration here first. Then you can take some cake to Grandma. How does that sound? I baked a nice cake for you, and we shall have a lovely dinner. And presents.
Oh, all right.
Good. Now, please go see if John is ready for his breakfast. Well, go on. Just because it's your birthday doesn't mean you can sit around all day.
Happy birthday.
tackle that girl.
She'll be fine, Mother.
You do not know that, so do not promise it.
Let me get that. You sit down. Come here.
The rain must be coming.
You just rest.
I hate resting.
No, you don't. Now look here, if we got anything to warm this tea up, it's bitter.
Oh, well, it is a little early in the day.
You know what I mean. I've got a sore throat coming on. I need it for my health.
Well, I do not think we have any.
I think we can find some somewhere around here. What's this then, eh? There we go. That's better. Right. Cheers!
Cheers. Oh, thank you.
We're like an old married couple, aren't we?
No, we are not.
Well, you're still beautiful, you know.
Stop it, John.
Come on. When your hair falls down your slender shoulders.
Grandmother is going to tell Lil.
What?
Grandmother is going to tell Lil about the arrangement.
What? Now?
Well, she's old enough to know, John.
What do you mean?
She has just turned 13. Now, I was 13 when
How do you know Grandmother's going to tell her?
I put a note for her in that basket.
Oh, God!
She's the best person to tell her.
Nobody's the best person to tell her! I'm not gonna marry Lillian! You and your arrangement!
Well, you know that it was what we decided. We love each other.
Yes.
We'll take care of her. She will make you happy.
We love each other as a father and a daughter. This is sick, Mother! You've ruined everything! Not yet, you have!
If you do not marry her, you will lose us both. If you do not marry Lillian, I will give her to one of the men who have asked for her, and we will go live with him. You can keep the house. I owe you at least that much for your sacrifice.
Sacrifice? I love you.
I'm not going to stay with you, John. I am not your wife, and I am most definitely not your lover.
Why do you torture me so? I would die for you, Mother, you know that.
You could not be happy with me.
I am happy with you, Sarah.
Oh, stop.
Please.
No.
Please, Sarah. I can't lose you. Sarah!
Oh! Give me my cape. You're just gonna let me crawl around like some animal?
killed anything before. I'm not going to kill you.
I'm the only wolf from these woods to have survived.
Sorry?
You're not going to kill me?
No.
I've never seen anything like you before.
I've never seen anything like you before.
Who are you? Tell me everything about you.
Well, my name is Lillian.
Lillian? That's a beautiful name.
Thank you. And what's your name?
I'm a wolf. I don't have a name.
You have to have a name. How do I call you if you don't have a name?
You could howl.
Howl?
We wolves, we howl.
What does that mean?
Well, like this. You try.
Oh!
Tell me more, I want to know. 13?
Yes, today's my birthday.
13 today? Happy birthday, Lillian.
Thank you.
Where are you going? What are you doing?
I'm going to my grandmother's cottage. We're going to have birthday cake.
Birthday cake?
Would you like to come with me?
No. No, I could not do that.
Oh. Very well.
Why do you look sad, Lillian?
Thought maybe we could be friends.
Friends?
No, never mind.
You wish to be friends with me?
I've never really had any real friends before. Except maybe my rabbits, the cats in the barn, and, well, John, of course.
I want to be friends with you, Lillian.
You do?
Yes. I think you are wonderful.
I think you're wonderful, too.
Then, we are friends.
We're friends! Oh, you'll come to grandmother's with me, then. Oh, she'll be so happy that I have a new friend. She'll be so excited.
No. I cannot do that. I cannot grant you that wish.
But why not? You'll just love grandmother.
Your grandmother is old, is she not?
Yes.
She was alive when the villagers killed all the wolves, was she not? She's one of them. I'm not blaming you, Lillian. You're too young. You were just a baby when it happened. But your grandmother...
My grandmother would never do something like that. I know she wouldn't.
I cannot go there, Lillian. I could die.
You're not going to die. I promise, nothing's going to happen to you.
Are you sure?
Yes. You'll see. Gran is the best. She's as good as gold.
Very well. I trust you, Lillian.
No, it's just that this path.
Who is John?
Huh?
Your friend.
Oh, that's John. Oh, John is the bravest, strongest, most amazing man in the whole village. Oh, we have such fun together. Well, sometimes we make Mother grumpy.
How do you know him?
Well, I've always known him. He lives with us.
He is your brother?
No, no, of course not.
Your uncle?
No, no, no.
Cousin? Nephew?
No.
Brother-in-law?
No.
Grandfather?
No, no, he's just John, that's all.
Your father doesn't mind him living with you.
I haven't got a father now. He died.
I'm sorry, Lillian.
No harm. It happened when I was just a baby. But John takes care of us, so everything is just fine.
How did your father die?
He died in an accident in the wood.
Did he?
Yes. Mother says the wood is dangerous. That's why I'm to always keep to the path. And even so,
dangerous place, but only to those who fear it. Humans are far more dangerous, because they wish to kill everything they fear.
I'm not afraid of the wood, but I'm not afraid of humans either.
Look what they did to me!
Oh, my. Oh, that's horrible. Does it still hurt?
Only when rain is coming.
No one I know would ever do something like that.
I hope not. But humans are very evil, Lillian. I don't believe it. We're different. That's why I think you would understand the wood. The wood is a beautiful place.
Yes, it is, isn't it?
This is nothing. You have to go deeper into the wood. That's where the true magic lies. But you have to go up the path to find it.
Well, I don't think I can do that. Maybe my 14th birthday I can go off the path. Oh, look! There's the bread cottage.
No. I do not think I'll come after all. Perhaps later. I'm sorry, Lillian. The time is not right.
Oh, very well. Well, next time then. Oh, I know. I'll tell Gran all about you this time, and how nice you are, and then she'll be sure to want to meet you.
Please, don't tell her about me. Not yet.
All right.
Promise?
Very well. I promise.
I'm very happy I met you.
Happy I met you too.
When will I see you again?
Oh, I don't know. Mother doesn't usually let me out of the house.
Well, you know how to call me.
Oh!
No! Not here! Not yet.
But why not?
It's not safe.
Very well.
Hey, may I have a kiss? Goodbye, Lily.
It's my birthday, girl. Oh, my, we are early, aren't we? I wasn't expecting you for several hours.
I couldn't wait to see you.
Oh, no, I forgot to play now, could I? How did we get here? Did we come alone?
Mother let me come all by myself because I'm 13 years old.
Oh, she did now, didn't she? Well, 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 well.
Do you want to see how tall I've grown?
Yeah.
I've grown a foot taller.
Oh, you have? Just look at you, twiddle it up.
Mother brought you a basket.
Oh, she did now, did she? Bless her. What have we here? What have we here? Do I see cake? Goodness gracious. Let's have tea and cake. May the good Lord bless.
So beautiful, Gran. I've never seen anything like it.
Oh, no. You would not have seen anything like it, though, would you?
But how did you make it? Where did you find this material that's so rich?
Oh, I made it quite some time ago. But it hasn't been worn since you were just a little baby now, has it? No, no. Not since then. I made it for your mother, Lillian. And I gave it to her on her 13th birthday, when I was preparing her for marriage to your father. And I'm giving it to you now, because your beauty is ready for a man. And there is something we have not told you. Something very important, but you were not ready until today. Today, on your 13th birthday, oh, Lillian, my dear, sweet girl, you are betrothed.
Betrothed?
To John the woodsman.
John?
I know it might seem surprising.
John!
But it's for the best.
John, my friend, John!
He will take care of you and make you happy.
I
will protect you.
I am not going to marry John.
It might seem strange at first, but in a very short time you will find that your love for him can change. He will be a very good husband for you and a good father for your children.
Children? Does John know about this?
Yes, he does. He has known since your father died.
Whose idea was this?
It was your father's idea.
My father's?
Was his dying wish, Lillian.
I will not marry John.
Oh, but my love, you have no choice.
I will run away.
Oh, where will you go?
I don't care.
Oh, Lillian, my dear, sweet girl, please sit down to calm yourself, won't you? Oh, let's have tea and cake now, shall we?
Tea?
It's a good girl.
No. I'm going now!
Lillian! Come back here!
Wolf? Fred? Help!
Lillian?
Where are you?
Here.
I do not see you.
I am here. Stay quiet. Do not fear. Watch the trees.
Time for you to go home now, Lillian. Follow my voice. I will lead you there. here soon.
What was that?
What was what?
I thought I heard something.
I didn't hear anything.
Huh. She's late.
She often stays out playing later than... Hey. Later than we tell her to.
Oh, we should not have let her walk all the way to grandmother's alone. Will you please go look out the window and check if you see her? What was that?
Nothing, just the wind.
Oh, I'm not an idiot, John.
What? I'm going out there. No, you stay here.
Where did you get that?
I'm sorry I was late.
Where did you get that?
Her grandmother.
Grandmother gave you that?
Yes, it was a present.
Grandmother gave you that cloak?
Yes.
What did she tell you about it?
Nothing.
Lillian, do not lie to me.
I'm not.
What did you and grandmother talk about today?
Nothing.
Well, you had to talk about something. Did you just sit there, mute?
No.
What did your grandmother tell you today?
Nothing.
Lillian, you are lying to me.
I am not.
What did you talk about today?
We talked about happy things. We talked about my birthday.
What did your grandmother tell you today? Take that thing off, please. Take it off. Take that filthy thing off!
It was a present.
Well, I will throw your precious present in the fire.
Mother, please, no, come on, let go. Let go. Mother, please, let go.
Bill? feel ill. I have to tell you about how your father died. I'm afraid you'll hate me.
I could never hate you, John.
Because it's my fault! I killed him! Before you were born, there was a kind of beast that lived in the woods. It was called a wolf. For many generations, the wolves hunted in the forest, and the humans and wolves did not harm each other. Well, around the time you were born, the wolves became aggressive. They started killing the farmers' livestock. And the villagers, they started killing the wolves in return. One wolf, the most evil of them all, he wasn't satisfied. He wanted human blood. He wanted to eat young girls. And the summer you were born, three girls died. They wandered into the woods, and the wolf killed them. Their bodies were found by woodsmen like myself and your father. One day, your father and I were working later than usual, and your mother got worried. She decided to come after us. We heard her calling to us, and we saw her a ways off. She was wearing this same red cloak, Lillian. And as we started towards her, the wolf sprang on her. Well, we ran to her, but by the time we got there, it already hurt her badly. Your father jumped on the wolf and tried to pull him off her, but he got her leg in his jaws and wouldn't let go. So I swung my axe. I hit the wolf. I hit your father also. And both the wolf and your father were wounded with one axe, my axe. Oh, Lillian, I'm so sorry. We tried to save him, but he was wounded too badly. The wolf got away, and as your father lay dying, he made me promise that I would...
I know, John.
You know?
I know. You made a promise.
Lil, I'm so sorry.
I went to the wood today, John.
You shouldn't.
The trees were alive. I danced with them.
Lillian.
You are strongest, bravest, most handsome man in the whole village, John.
Lillian.
I want to go to the wood with you.
The wood is a dangerous place, Lil.
That is a lie.
Please.
Take me.
What? I cannot.
Please.
No!
down trees and kill animals. You know nothing of the wood. You know nothing of the wolves. But I know.
Queen of the wood.
Of the wood?
Yes.
Now you have only human blood in you. You must taste some of mine. And I will taste yours. And together, we will have the power of man and beast combined. You want that?
Yes! Yes!
Are you ready?
Come into bed with me.
John.